Scleroderma Foundation have asked me to do a talk on art therapy and how art can be used as part of one's therapy. I'm feeling good about it because I've been doing art to help me cope to live well with scleroderma for 29 years. And I'm pretty excited to give this talk to everybody. You know, I really am excited to have that they're going to have a great speaker.
I have another deep dark secret. I just have to love to paint funky chickens all the time. I don't know why, I just love it. And I have another secret, very important secret, that I use art, writing, as a part of my therapy in coping and living well with chronic illness. Because creativity can lead to problem solving. And art therapy can help you focus. Because everybody knows how difficult it affects your hands. Everybody, your hands, right? And every part of your body. Help you focus. Because you gotta keep mobile, you gotta keep it moving, very fluid. Difficult physical work like roofing. And you don't even want to clean your bathroom. Because that's also very difficult too. And everybody agree with me on that? Cleaning your bathroom is very difficult for your hands. But there are other things you can do, like sweeping, mopping. I can do that great. And so I kept doing tasks, like long tweezers are good to have. Long tweezers. I don't know if anybody has long tweezers. They're really great. And that big long arm thing. And the next point I had is good at problem solving and communication skills. Often, I have four sisters, one has passed away. One particular sister I have is very hard to talk to. It's not that I'm not a good communicator or anything. It's just sometimes with family, it just goes back too deep. I mean, all of you could probably talk to her fine, and John would probably be perfect to talk to her, and Peter's even better. Sometimes communications and also help is also helped by redirecting. Redirecting, when I have frustration with my particular sister, I will have to step away. And then I have to jump back into my craft room and do crafts. What could I do better? Sometimes I have to step back again to redirect. And I'll ask Peter here, what can I do better to communicate? And he would have good suggestions. And I go, okay, I can just use him. I can take this criticism. And I go, so when I jump back and talk to her, I use them, but I don't give him no credit. And that's a lot better than before. It's a little voice in our head that tells us we can't do something. And I get that all the time, but it's becoming less and less. It's taken me a long time to grow up and mature about that. I think maturity takes a long time. So it's quieting down. I still fight. I'm sure everybody has that voice that says, you can't do this. And I thought about this, and everybody's probably seen this gal here at the in Los Angeles. She's been diagnosed 2 years ago. She goes to UCLA. I don't think she might be talking back because I already got her permission. In fact, early this year, she asked me, can you draw a picture of myself? I said, sure. I didn't know how I'm going to do it. So I did it on cotton. She kind of didn't like the nose. It was really hard. And she said, it's hard doing nose. I said, I fixed it. I learned this technique, how to do color on fabric. We use markers, alum. And I showed everybody at the beginning of the show and tell. You're a show and tell. We all live in show and tell. And the ladies over there, there's like 100 ladies. It's a guild of 180 women. And sometimes women are very hard to work with. There was this crowd over there. They were just laughing and making fun of me when I showed this. And a few weeks later, I had entered it into a contest. No, it can happen. I got a reward. They didn't laugh at me at that point. They had a lot of esteem. So stress is also a big part of our scleroderma. When I was in the military, it was very stressful working with men that didn't understand me. The perfect storm. The stress I had in the military. My family doesn't understand it too. I wrote this essay, use creative art therapy to rise above physical limitation. You know, food got all over it. But with that, you know, I got an award for that. Just write about anything. It doesn't matter if it's your family, your bad doctor's appointment, just keep writing something. Just keep, as they tell me in my writer's room, in Mesa, just throw up on it. Just throw up on it, and then if you want someone to edit it, just talk to me or join a writing group. Because in my writing group, someday is like pick on Lucy Day. And that's okay with me. This is the sense that you can use art, music, and writing as your therapy. It's not easy to handle chronic illness, I know it. Most people do not handle it well. So when someone keeps it together, I really admire it. I know what it takes. I think it takes more than hope. It takes determination, boundless determination. Because hope is not enough. It's more bound and determined to let art, writing, and music be your inspiration. Let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, let's do it, cause I got a feeling.